What is up? It's Mikey, and today we're going over step one, how to get the sleeper simulant in Destiny, probably one of the most sought after weapons because nobody has it. So let's get into it. This is what it looks like, by the way. Really cool weapon. Looks like it's made out of computer parts, rubber tubing, and zip ties. Really neat, exotic fusion rifle. Let's get into it. So the first step is you need to play the quest, The First Firewall. And this is available once you've turned in the four fusion parts, the four fusion relics that fell randomly during PvE all these weeks. Okay, you need to have four of them and you would have turned them in this whole time. If you haven't played enough Destiny, well, you gotta keep playing until you randomly get them, okay? All right, so if you've already done that, you should just be able to log in and there it is. It's gonna be right on Earth, The First Firewall level 41 quest, recommended light 260. All right, so make your way through the mission, head to the Seraphim Vault at the very end, and you notice how these enemies are spawning in. They never spawn like this, right? In a little perfect line. And there's a reason for that. And somebody, I wish I knew who, so we can give them credit, some guy in a random chat room, he figured out this was a code. Let me slow it down for you. You see, you got the Dark Knight, white, dark, dark, white, white. And that's gonna come into play a little bit later on, all right? But let's get into defeating these guys. If you played in this room before, I mean, we all pretty much have, you know the strategy. You can run around in a circle pretty much. If you're solo, you're definitely gonna have to run around. It's definitely possible solo, but you know, just keep moving. It would help if you had some raid weapons, but definitely have something arc because you will encounter arc shields. Once you beat all those dudes, there's about four rounds of them. You got the final boss, Kandarak. He's a pain in the butt, but once you take him down, you get awarded the Curious Transceiver. Well, what's that? So we go ahead and click on it. Curious Transceiver. The transceiver is broadcasting a signal encrypted with a simple passcode. And you can go ahead and hit Y or triangle to put in your passcode. And here's the first one. I'll just go ahead and keep the screen static. You guys can pause it if you want to. The code is actually the order that those knights are in, okay? So we're gonna use one for the top and two for the bottom. So the first code is 12112212. And when you do that, you get another Curious Transceiver. Go ahead and click on that, and now we have the next screen. Here it is. You can go ahead and pause it. I'll go through it pretty slow. It's 12112211, and then you can click on submit passcode, and it'll tell you, it appears you entered the correct sequence. Go ahead and hit that. You get another one. Same thing. Here it is for number three. 12212211, and then you can submit passcode. And then we get the fourth and final transceiver. Here is the code, 12121211, and then it changes. Activate transceiver, prerequisites passed, beacon enabled. Go ahead and hit that, and then it says Curious Transceiver broadcasting. What's it broadcasting? I don't know, but now this unlocks Shadow Call. It's a level 41 quest, recommended light is 270. So when you play this quest, you have to climb up the tower in about 5 minutes. Honestly, it is relatively easy. Just run past all the enemies. Do not stop for any of them. You will have plenty of time to make it to the top of the tower. Even if you screw up a bunch of times like me, you'll still have like 2 minutes left. Once you get to the top, there's going to be a chest. Go ahead and open it up, and it's gonna be empty, nothing in there. Instead, you get to kill off three hollowed wizards. Okay, they're not so tough. Go ahead and kill all three of them. And when you do that, you get Aikilos Fusion Core. And what is this? Well, this is basically where you need to complete five tasks. So let's go through each task, easiest first. First one is Heavy Power Coupling. The quantum dots found in any heavy power would fit here. Basically, it's telling you to dismantle a legendary or exotic heavy weapon. If you don't have anything and you happen to have a lot of weapon cores, you can head to Variks and go ahead and get you a cheap machine gun, and that'll do fine. But once you defuse that heavy weapon, you get the Heavy Power Coupling. and you can go ahead and click on your relic and select, and it'll go ahead and put that in, and we can move on to our next task. Ionized shell harmonics, and it's got this weird code and stuff, but the last line says Ishtar Archives. You remember that mission? It's one of the first missions in the game, level 12 story. We're gonna head to Venus, the archive. It's insanely easy, okay? No strats needed here. And so when you pass this, you get ionized shell harmonics. And we're gonna go ahead and click on our fusion core again. Go ahead and hover over it, hit select. And now we can move on to the last three tasks. Now these are very, very easy. All you gotta do is complete a Defend the Warsap public event on Earth, Moon, and Mars. Really easy, right? The problem is waiting around for them. So much time is gonna be wasted waiting around unless you get lucky and you happen to come across when the Warsap falls down. And it has to be a public event. So if you're thinking about playing Fallen Saber or a Strike or something, it's not gonna work. It has to be a public event, okay? Get ready to sit around for a while. So there are websites that help you. There's a few of them. I'll have a link down below. Here's Destiny Public Events. It's kind of accurate. I would wait around maybe 5 minutes before, 5 minutes after the time it says. They have little icons there that tell you what each thing means, but it'll be something random. Sometimes the Taken will show up. If the Taken show up, just leave, go somewhere else. Sometimes a target will come up. It's gonna be really, really frustrating. So get ready for that. So once you defeat each Warsat, you get a plasma confinement control module. On Earth, I got module number 1. I head to the Moon, plasma confinement control module number 2. And then finally on Mars, plasma confinement control module 3. Get all the modules, place them where they're supposed to be, and then we unlock our final little task there, reactivate core. All the components appear to be functioning properly. The fusion core is ready to be restarted. So go ahead and start it up. And now you have reassembled Aikilo's fusion core. And all you gotta do now is give the core to Banshee 44. And so we go ahead, head of the tower, hand it to him, and he's like, cool, thanks. I'm gonna show it to my friends in a nutshell, and nothing happens. That is the end of step one. Nobody knows besides Bungie. We don't know, but I will definitely keep you guys updated on this. Anyways, if you want to come out to the open lobbies and live streams, things like that, Twitter, Facebook, links down below. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. See you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Destiny tips, tricks, info, glitches, all kinds of stuff. It's a playlist. I try to keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side, got the same thing, but for Call of Duty info, tips, tricks, news, all sorts of stuff, you can click on the screen or links down below.